This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so the today agenda is based on the layout designing process. So in the layout designing process, the two method is very famous. One is a micron rule, another is a lambda based design rule. So these are the two rules are very, very popular nowadays for the layout designing process. The first rule is a micron rule, and the second rule is a lambda based design rules. Okay, so what is the meaning of layout? So layout is the feature size representation. Okay, just I write here, layout is the features size representation. Okay, what is the meaning here? Whatever the layer you are using in the layout, you just specify the size. What is the size of your layers? Means what is the width of your layer and what is the length of the layer? That is known as a feature size. If this information is available in your layout, if this information or feature size, means your W or L information, is available in your layout, so that is your complete layout process. Okay, so now if your layout is complete, then you contact the fab industry. Okay, some fabrication industry is there. Fabrication industry. Okay, so that industry has fabricate your design, whatever your design based on the layout. But okay, after the fabrication process, this is your product. What is your product? Product means your IC chip or integrated circuit is a chip. After the fabrication, the product is a chip. So this is a hardware part. Okay, so this is a hardware part, and here in the hardware is a real-time simulation. We say that is a real-time hardware. Okay, so that is only possible if your layout is complete and this layout is submit to the fab industry or fabrication industry. And they have this industry, fabrication industry, has fabricate the integrated circuit or your chip. Okay, so you know the chip is like this. This is your chip, this is a boundary, and here some pin is available. Okay, maybe 7 pin or maybe 14 pin. Everything is based on your complexity of the circuit. If your circuit is like a simple network, a simple circuit, or a complex network, then your pin is maybe more or maybe less. So if the circuit is simple, number of pin is less. If the circuit is complex, number of pin is more, because here in the complex circuit, number of output or number of input is more. That means the pin size, the pin number is increased. So that is a one way. So our agenda is the, we learn the rules of the fabrication process. Okay, so that is the overview. I think that you understand the layout. In the layout, you require the feature size. What is your feature size of your device? Okay, your device may be your inverter network, inverter circuit, or maybe CMOS NAND, or maybe half adder or full adder, or maybe ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, or maybe processor. If anything, it is possible. So the layout is a rule. Okay, so now here the two methods are very famous nowadays for the layout designing process. One is a micron rule, another is a lambda based design rule. So we study one by one all these rules. So first we study this method, and then we study this method. These two method has a different methodology. So what is the meaning of methodology? So methodology is the method, or we say that it is the rule. So if you understand the all the rules of the micron, or we say that is a lambda based rule, then you understand the complete layout process. Okay, so we move to one by one, and you understand the layout process, layout designing process. So one thing you have just understand, your objective is same in these two method. Your objective is same. What is your objective? Your objective is the layout design. You have to farm out the layout, but it is your choice. It is your choice what method you have adopt. You adopt a micron rule or lambda based rule. It is your choice. It is not very much constraints or something limitation. No, I will use only this rule. So it is based on the choice. It is based on your choice. You use micron rule. This is a one rule. Another is a lambda based rule. Okay, so that is the only two method are available nowadays, or in the industry are using these two rule for the layout designing process. Okay, so that is your choice. You use micron rule or you use lambda rule for the layout process. Okay, so this is not a limitation. Anything you use for the layout process, in both the rules, industry are capable to fabricate your IC, integrated circuit, or VLSI circuit. Okay, so here there is no issue. I think you understand what is my objective, what our objective. Our objective is the layout process. We design some layout based on the protocol. What is my protocol? Okay, so we understand the protocol process. We understand the rules first, and then we go for the layout process. Okay, so I will move to one by one. This is a one micron rule, another is a lambda based rule. So first we move to, first we start the second method. This is a two method. So now we move to the lambda based design rule. In the lambda based design rule, first we understand the concept, and then we move to the, so we take some example like CMOS NAND gate or CMOS NOR gate, and according to the lambda based design rule we have to form some layout process. Okay, so here just I given the overview in this slide. The lambda based design rule is developed by, this is a scientist, Mead and Conway. So Mead and Conway has developed some protocols, some rules. That is a lambda rule. That is a lambda rule. So what is the meaning of lambda? Just you understand here. If suppose that whatever your device, every device has a certain limitation, means every device has a certain dimension. Without, beyond this dimension, suppose that my device length is 0.1. Okay, suppose that I just given an overview. Okay, suppose that my dimension is 0.1 micrometer. Okay, suppose that I have used one device. This device dimension is 0.1 micrometer. So according to the micron rules, this is considered as one lambda. Okay, so this is considered as one lambda. Here we do not use 0.1 micrometer. So this is equivalent to one lambda. One lambda. Similarly, if any other device, the size is 0.2 micrometer, so that means in this methodology, the dimension is two lambda. Okay, the dimension is two lambda. So the minimum size of the device, or we say that minimum features, the minimum spacing is only 0.1, and this is the minimum length is one lambda. So one lambda is possible, two lambda is possible, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, everything is possible. But the minimum width or minimum feature size is one lambda. So that is the important point you have to observe very carefully in the lambda-based design rule. In the lambda-based design rule, you required a minimum 1 lambda size. This 1 lambda size is considered as 0.1. Okay, this minimum length size is considered as 1 lambda. Okay, so this is a one point. This is a one point. And the second very important point, all the dimensions. Suppose that I use some, maybe I use some other dimension like some, okay, you know this, all the process, you have some layers. Suppose that this is one layer. Okay, so this layer has a dimension. Suppose that this layer is a poly layer. Okay, suppose that in your layout you required one poly layer. Okay, but here the poly layer has a certain dimension. So this dimension is 2 lambda. Okay, I will discuss what is the rule, and this is also 2 lambda. Okay, every dimension is required dimension in terms of lambda only. So lambda is 0.1. So this is 0.2 dimension, 0.2 micrometer. Okay, so this you care about. If you follow all the rules, if you follow all the protocols, then you are capable to convert to the layout process. Your layout, your implementation is start. Implementation is possible in some industry. Okay, so now we move to one by one. There is no any issue. Okay, suppose that in one case, if you reduce the dimension, suppose that my total size of the device is L. Okay, my total dimension of the device is L, but I reduce the dimension. Suppose that I reduce this dimension, and this is also in form of lambda, not in L by 2. It is represented in form of lambda. So you know the lambda is 0.1. The minimum size is only 0.1. Okay. So that you also represent. If your dimension is less, your lambda is also change. Your feature size of the transistor is also change. Because many times the device are to be shrink. Okay. If you go for the minimum area, if your requirement is minimum area, okay, so that means you have to reduce the dimension. And if your L is changed, suppose that your L is changed, of course my L lambda is also changed. So previously my lambda is equal to L, but now this time is L by 2. So this is also effect on the lambda. Okay, this is also effect on the dimension of lambda. Your dimension is also changed. If your length is changed, your device feature size is changed, your lambda is also effect. Okay, so this is the one way, but our agenda is we study all the rules first. Okay, here in the lambda based design rule, in the lambda based design rules, what is the every layers. Suppose that many layer are there. This is one layer and another. This is also one layer. Every layer is represented by the lambda. Okay. And here, if the two layers are available, some spacing is there in these two layer. This is also limitation. In these two layer, you have to minimum spacing is required. Otherwise, the signal is not pass here. Whatever the information in this layer, this is not passed in this layer. Again, your output is to be affect. Your output is not, maybe there is some degradation or voltage level is maybe decreased. So this is a one issue. But here, if you follow the rules, if you follow the according to the specification, all the layers specification, all the spacing, then you are capable to implement the IC, whatever your IC. So that is just overview. I just given an overview. That means you follow the rules. You follow the dimension. of every layer, and you also follow the minimum spacing size. If you maintain all these rules, all this protocol in your design, then your means something, your layout is effectively, your layout is effective and the fabrication is possible. Okay, so that is that we have to study in this topic. We have to learn the all the dimensions of different layers. Whatever your layer is metal and diffusion, pure diffusion, and one layer is metal, another is a end diffusion, pure diffusion, and a poly layer. So if you use these type of layer in your layout, you required a proper dimension. So that is the rules of the lambda based. Okay, so now we move to very slowly, we do not go far immediately. Okay, we go fast slowly. So now I will discuss here in this slide. So please understand this one. We learn the rules. What is the rules? Your dimensions, proper dimensions, proper spacing. What is the proper spacing in the form of lambda? In the form of dimension lambda. Okay, so one lambda is 0.1 micrometer. Okay, so this already you know this one. So the lambda is represented in the micrometer also, but in the layout process of the lambda based design rule, we have only representation of in the lambda form, maybe one lambda or two lambda or maybe six lambda also. Okay, anything is possible. Okay, so no problem, just I go for slowly. Okay, so I discuss these three layer. Okay, one layer is a diffusion, end diffusion. Okay, so this is a green color. I think you know this color specification, otherwise I again write. So please remember this color coding, this because the color coding is required for the layout process. So in case of end diffusion, if you use layer, this is end diffusion layer. Suppose that this is end diffusion layer. This color is green. Okay, please note down this one. This color is green. Okay, so this layer end diffusion is represented by green. Okay, similarly, if this layer is P, if suppose that you are used the poly layer, you are used the poly silicon. So the color coding is red. This is represented by red. Okay, so this is a general specification I already discussed in the previous lecture in case of stick diagram. Okay, so one thing you observe here, this is a three layer. Okay, one layer is a p diffuser, end diffusion, poly layer, and p diffuser. Okay, so now we discuss the rules. What is the rules? Okay, suppose that you use sometimes one diffusion and p diffuser. Suppose that I use the two layer, one layer is end diffusion, another is a p diffuser. Okay, so this is the end diffusion and this is a p diffuser. So the rule is this dimension is two lambda. Okay, so this dimension is two lambda. You require this limit. Okay, you require this limit. So end diffusion is two lambda, the width of the end diffusion is two lambda, and here is also two lambda. Okay, the p diffusion length is also two lambda. It is the rule. You maintain all this time in the layout process. Otherwise, your signal is not propagate from one place to another place. So the conclusion here: if the p diffusion and end diffusion layers are available, then every layer the dimension is 2 lambda. Okay, every layer the dimension is 2 lambda. Okay, so please you note down this one. Okay, so this is the one point. Okay, so now we move to one more important point for spacing, for spacing purpose. So if suppose that this is a case, this is a case for 2 layer, but now I use 4 layer. This is one layer, this is another layer, and this is one more layer, and this is a one more layer. Okay, so the 4 layer is there. One layer is N, this is P, and this is N, this is P. Okay, so the 4 layer is available. One is N diffusion, this is N diffusion, this is P diffusion, this is N diffusion, this is P diffusion. Okay, one rule I already learned, this all the dimension is 2 lambda. Okay, so this is also 2 lambda, this is also 2 lambda, this is also 2 lambda. So all these layers, the width of every layer is 2 lambda. So this is one thing we already learned. But here, if you use 2 layer in this way, that means some spacing is required in these 2 layer. So what is the specification here? 3 lambda you maintain the distance. This is also 3 lambda. At least you require 3 lambda spacing in between 2 layer. One layer is this and one layer is this. So at least you have to maintain these specification if your layout has a 4 number of layers. So minimum requirement or minimum spacing requirement is 3 lambda. Please you remember this concept, please you note down this one, this 3 lambda and this 2 lambda. Every layer, whatever your diffusion, maybe N type N diffusion or maybe P diffusion, every layer width is 2 lambda, and the spacing between 2 layer must be 3 lambda. Minimum 3 lambda, more than no problem, but minimum 3 lambda is required. Otherwise your signal is not passed from in this information is not passed to here or something may be problem. So that specification or that rules you kept in mind before the layout process. Before go for the final implementation, this is a top level implementation. In the top level implementation, you have to maintain all these specification. Okay, so this is a one way. Okay, one thing, one more interesting point. Here 3 lambda you have maintained in case of N diffusion and P diffusion. But now I use one more layer. This is a poly layer. Okay, suppose that this is a poly layer in my layout. So this is a general example. Okay, so this is a poly layer. Okay, so the poly layer is red color. Okay, so the poly layer is red color. The problem is what is the spacing between these layer? So if the poly layer and the diffusion layer, in this is a diffusion layer, so the minimum spacing is 1 lambda. Minimum spacing is 1 lambda in between poly and the diffusion layer. So if the poly layer and the diffusion layer is very very near to each other, here this is a case, this is observation here, this diffusion layer and the poly layer are very, very near to each other. So in this case, the minimum spacing is 1 lambda. The minimum spacing is 1 lambda. You have to maintain this minimum requirement. Okay, so that is known as a lambda based design rule. If the diffusion layer and the poly layer are near to each other, so in that case the spacing between these two layer is 1 lambda. So that you have to maintain before go for the final implementation of the layout. Whatever your circuit, the circuit, I have not talked about your circuit, I have talked about your specifications, your dimensions, proper dimensions. So that you have to care about in all the times. So the minimum spacing is 1 lambda. Okay, more than 1 lambda is no any problem, but you have to maintain 1 lambda. In case of poly layer, this is a poly layer and this is a diffusion layer. So in this case, you have to maintain this dimension 1 lambda. Okay, so this is the one rule. But one more interesting case here, suppose that I have used one more poly layer in this side, one more poly layer. So again, my poly layer color is red color. This is a red color. Poly is represented by is red color. Okay. So now, if in this case my two poly layer are near to each other. Okay. So 1 minute. Okay. So if the two poly layer are near to each other. So this is the one case. If the two poly layer are very near to each other, so in this case, if suppose that in the previous case the diffusion layer and the poly layer spacing is 1 lambda. Okay, so now in this case, if two poly layer are very near to each other, the separation is 2 lambda. Okay, the separation or minimum requirement of the spacing is 2 lambda. Okay, so this poly layer is 2 lambda. You know this one, the poly layer dimension is 2 lambda. This width is 2 lambda. But here spacing is also 2 lambda. At least you have to maintain this distance. The proximity distance you have to maintain in case of layout process is 2 lambda. Okay, so that you care about. Please you care about this. Specification. Please, you care about this specification for the layout designing process. So again, just I review what I have discussed here. If the N diffusion and P diffusion are available very near to each other, suppose that this is a P diffusion and this is an N diffusion. If these two layer are near to each other, so the dimension is 3 lambda. Okay, so please note down, if the diffusion layer are near to each other, the minimum spacing is 3 lambda. And another point, the diffusion layer and the poly layer, the diffusion layer and the poly layer spacing is 1 lambda. Okay. And the third important point, if the two poly layer are near to each other, the spacing is 2 lambda. Okay, the spacing is 2 lambda. Okay, so these are the three very important point you have to care about all the times. So if the diffusion layer, if the diffusion layer and the, if two diffusion layer are near to each other, the dimension, the spacing is 3 lambda. And if the diffusion layer and the poly layer are near to each other, the dimension is 1 lambda, and if the two poly layer are near to each other, the spacing is 2 lambda. Okay, so the three points you have to kept in your mind for the layout designing process. Okay, so I hope you have to understand this point, and all the layers. Suppose that this N diffusion and P diffusion, the dimension is 2 lambda. Okay, this N diffusion is 2 lambda, P diffusion width is also 2 lambda. Okay, so again another point, if the P diffusion, this is a P diffusion and this is the also P diffusion, the spacing is 3 lambda. Okay, the spacing is 3 lambda. And if the diffusion layer and the poly layer are near to each other, the spacing is 1 lambda. Okay, if the diffusion layer and the poly layer are near to each other, the spacing is 1 lambda. Okay, so, and one more point, if the two poly layer, this is one layer, poly layer, and this is also poly layer, so the spacing between two layer is 2 lambda. Okay, the spacing is between two poly layer is 2 lambda. Okay, so this is a rule for the lambda based design rule. So all the layers are represented in the lambda form. So 1 lambda is 0.1 micrometer in terms of micrometer. Okay, so in terms of micrometer, the dimension is 1 lambda is 0.1 micrometer. So if the 3 lambda is available, what is the dimension? What is the dimension here? 3 lambda is equal to 0.3 micrometer. Because here 1 lambda is 0.1 micrometer. So the 3 lambda is 0.3 micrometer. Okay, so this is 0.3 micrometer. Okay, so this is 0.3 micrometer. So what is this? What is this? This is 0.3 micrometer. Okay. Okay, just I given a very, very good picture for you. So this is 0.2. This is 0.3 micrometer. And this is 0.1 micrometer. Okay, and this is 0.2 micrometer. 2 lambda means 0.2 micrometer. Okay, so these are the conversion in terms of micrometer from lambda to micrometer. So these are the conversion from lambda to micrometer scale. So this is a scale conversion. Okay, so you also remember this one. 1 lambda is 0.1 micrometer. Okay, so the 3 lambda is 0.3 micrometer, the 1 lambda is 0.1 micrometer, the 2 lambda is 0.2 micrometer. So if you represent in the micrometer range, so this is the small conversion. Okay, so this lambda is allocated to 0.1 micrometer. So here I think it is clear, it is no any problem. What is the spacing in all the layers? And what is the dimension, what is the feature size of all the layers? Every layer has 2 lambda, and here the something is spacing is sometimes 3 lambda, 1 lambda or 2 lambda, and then you care about these all the specification, all the rules. Okay, so now we move to the second part. Okay, so one thing, here some rules in this slide. Okay, two layers are available. One is a metal one and another is a metal two. So I think you have clear this picture. My picture is clear. My slide is visible. So this is a metal one and this is a metal two. So this is used in case of PMOS. In case of PMOS design, you have used the metal two layer. Okay, so again, there is a probability. Probability means if two layers are near to each other, metal one, metal two, what is the spacing, what is the dimension, and what rules we are what protocol we have to follow. Okay, so now we discuss in this slide what is the minimum spacing are required, what is the minimum spacing are required, and what is the what is the dimension, what is the feature dimension of the layout. Okay, so now we move to one by one. Okay, so this is a metal one, this is a metal one layer. Okay, and this is also metal one. Okay, so this is also metal one layer. So these two layer are available. Okay, so these two layer are available. This is a metal one and this is a metal two. Okay, so now if the two metal layers are available very near to each other, first point you remember. Okay, just I discuss here. First point you remember, if one is a metal layer and this is also metal layer. Okay, so this dimension is 3 lambda. This is a metal one. Okay, so this is a metal two. Okay, this metal two is also 3 lambda. This dimension is 3 lambda. This is also 3 lambda. Okay, but here one more thing: if the two layers are very very near to each other, so what is the spacing in these two layer? This is also 3 lambda. So please note down this one. Okay, no, this one is metal one. Okay. So if the two metal layer are very near to each other, if the two metal layers are very near to each other, metal one, I have talked about only metal one. So here this is a small description or a small observation here. If two layers, metal layers, if two metal layers are there, this is a 3 lambda and this is also 3 lambda. And the spacing is 3 lambda. This is spacing is 3 lambda. Okay, so please you remember about this point in case of metal one layer. If the metal layer are very close to each other, the minimum spacing is 3 lambda is required for the correct formation of the layout. Okay. So I think you have to understand this point. If the two metal layers are very near to each other, the dimension is 3 lambda. Okay, so there is no issue. Okay, so now we talk about metal two. So metal two is used in the PMOS design. In case of PMOS design, the metal two layers are used. Okay, so one more thing here. If the two metal two layer are available now, suppose that one my metal layer one is this one metal layer two and this is another metal layer two. So this is a metal two. Okay, so this is a metal layer two. Okay, so this spacing is 3 lambda. Okay, so I will show in the picture, it is more 4 lambda. Just I zoom out. Okay, so I think it is clear. Okay, now I have zoom out. So this is a metal two, this is a metal two layer, this is a metal two, this is also metal two. Okay, so the dimension is 4 lambda. This is 4 lambda. I think it is clear. And this is also 4 lambda. And the spacing in these two layer is 4 lambda. Okay, the spacing between these two layer is 4 lambda. Okay, so please you note, please you remember this protocol or rule for the designing layout designing process. Okay, so now this is finished. This part is finished, metal layer, and also I convert the we also understand the end diffusion and poly layer separation in the previous slide, already discussed. Okay, so now one more important things just I zoom out. First we concentrate on this diagram. Okay, just we concentrate on this diagram. So what is this diagram? Actually, here, just I show here in this slide. Okay, so if the one thing, if the suppose that your end diffusion layer is there, this is end diffusion layer. Okay, this is end diffusion. Okay, so now we note down here what is end diffusion. So this is the end diffusion layer, end diffusion. Okay, so this is the end diffusion. Okay, and if the end diffusion layer, if the end diffusion layer is crossed by poly layer, this is a poly layer. Okay, this is a poly layer. Okay, so this poly layer is crossed to end diffusion. This is a poly layer. Okay, so you know the poly layer is represented by red color, and the end diffusion is represented by green color. So here the important observation is actually this is a n-type transistor. Okay, this is a n-type transistor. So you know the n-type transistor is two type. One is the enhancement, another is the depletion. But how to identify this is the enhancement type or p-type? What is the identification mark? So here, if the yellow color, suppose that one box is there, one box in the yellow color in the outside, in this box is available, then it is a depletion type. Then it is a depletion. Okay, note down here. Okay, so please note down this one. If the yellow color box is available in this layout, this is the depletion type transistor. So this is a NMOS depletion transistor. Okay, so this is a representation. Depletion. So this is the n-type depletion layout. Okay, so now what is the conclusion? If the yellow color box is available in the outside, this is a yellow color, this is a n-type depletion transistor. Okay, so please note down this one. It is a very very important concept to understand the transistors. So n-type depletion, is possible if the yellow color box is available here. This yellow color box is available here. That means this is the n-type depletion mode transistor. Okay, so now how to represent the n-type enhancement type transistor. How to represent the n-type enhancement type transistor? So you required one poly layer. Okay, so this is n diffusion. Okay, and this layer is a poly layer. This layer is poly. So here in this case, yellow color box is not there. In the previous case, yellow color box is available, but now in this layout, this yellow color box is not available, not there. So the significance is this is the representation of NMOS. This is a representation of NMOS enhancement. Okay, this is an NMOS enhancement. Okay, so please note down this one. This is an NMOS enhancement type transistor. Okay, this is an NMOS enhancement type transistor. So what is the conclusion? Here yellow color box is not available. Then this is an enhancement type transistor. If the yellow color box is available, then it is a depletion type transistor. So suppose that I put one yellow color box. Now it is a depletion. This transistor is an n-type diffusion. Okay, so I think you know this. You remember this concept. Now I remove this one. If I remove this yellow color, okay, so this is a enhancement. This is an enhancement. Now I have put here yellow color box. This is a depletion. This is a depletion and MOS depletion type transistor. So that is a representation of the in the layout process. This is a representation of the transistors. So now you understand the n-type transistors, how to represent the n-type transistors in terms of layout. In your layout, how to design the NMOS transistor. You require one poly layer, you require one n diffusion, and one outside box. If box is not there, then it is an enhancement. If box are available, yellow color box, it is a depletion. And all these layers is 2 lambda. This is a 2 lambda, and this is also 2 lambda. So what is the total dimension? If you talk about the total dimension, so this is 2 lambda multiply 2 lambda. So this is the dimension of this layout. Okay, so this is the dimension of this layout. Okay, but I assume that here yellow color box is not here. If the yellow color box is available, again this is a 2 lambda. So this is a 6 lambda. I represent here in the slide. Okay, so just I zoom out. Okay, so this is a one example. So here in this picture, yellow color box not there. So this is an enhancement. Okay. Similarly, in this diagram, yellow color box not there. This is enhancement. Okay, so this is enhancement. And this is a poly. This red is a poly. And this green color is a P diffusion. Okay, so this green color is a P diffusion. So that is a P type. That means it is a P type. Similarly, this is a poly and this is a N diffusion. So that means it is a NMOS. But here, yellow color box not there. That means the enhancement. So now we go for last figure. In the last figure, here yellow color box is there. Yes, yellow color box is available. So this is a poly. This is your poly layer, and this is your N diffusion. So that is the NMOS. There is no issue. But here yellow color box is available. So this dimension is also, this is 2 lambda. This is also 2 lambda. Poly layer is also 2 lambda, and this yellow color box is also 2 lambda. So if you talk about the total length, so here 2 lambda, this is also 2 lambda, this is also 2 lambda, and this is also 2 lambda. So this is a 6 lambda. Total size is 6 lambda in terms of length, and in terms of width, is also same. So 6 lambda multiply 6 lambda. So this is a dimension in case of complete layout process. I think this you understand very carefully. Okay, so this is a actual lambda based design rule. So in the lambda based design rule,